So hello guys, welcome back to Match Live. Of course, the best when it comes to giving you the latest and the best in the world of football and generally in sports. I know it's been a while, but I am back with some very interesting news concerning the sale of Manchester United, because the sale at this point has entered its second phase. And what I mean by the second phase is that the bidders have already submitted their initial bids. The club has reviewed them, and of course they have been described as quite good, and so the club is giving a green light to these bidders to of course submit their second bids, which are expected to be of course improved. And since the Glazers of course announced their interest in seeking new investment plans into the club, two bidders or two main bidders have shown interest in buying Manchester United, and that is Sheikh Jassim of Adani of Qatar, and of course Sir Jim Ratcliffe. And they are not the only ones, but they are the main bidders who have of course tabled bids and of course publicly announced that they have made these bids. And since then, what happened is that the club set the first soft deadline. It has been described as soft deadline because it's not the last deadline, because there will be the second bid, probably even the third bid. I don't know if it will happen, but if the second bid is pleasing enough to the Rain Group and the owners, of course the Glazers, I don't think there will be need for the third bid. So what happened ever since November, when the Glazers announced their interest in selling the club or seeking new investment plans, is that different bidders of course came up, as I have said, about Sheikh Jassim and Sir Jim Ratcliffe. They have tabled their first bid before the deadline last month, and now the club has reviewed these bids and they think maybe it might not be what they want at the moment, but given a chance to visit the Old Trafford facilities, the Carrington and so on, and of course given the chance to make another bid, it might be suitable for them. And so for the Glazers, according to what I've heard from some tier one sources in England, is that they are they value the club at around £6 billion, but up to this time no bidder has made such a bid, because the first one, which is the highest, is from Sheikh Jassim of Qatar, and it has been of course described or estimated to be in the region of £4.5 billion. So it's not up to what the Glazers or up to the Glazers valuation, but it's quite close. And that's why now, entering the second phase, or before entering the second phase, the club has invited these bidders, Sir Jim and Sheikh Jassim, to Old Trafford and training Carrington training facilities, so that they can first of all look at these facilities and know what are we buying. Of course, how much will we invest in this club after buying it? You know, even if, for example, if you want to buy a car, you must first of all review how good it is, or after buying it, how will you of course invest more into doing repairs and so on. And so that's the same thing that has been happening at United this week, and it started on Thursday when of course Sheikh Jassim's delegation, he was not there, but his delegation visited Old Trafford and Carrington training facilities and spent almost estimated 10 hours of course reviewing and of course looking at these facilities and knowing what are we buying, so that by the time they are making their second bid, they will make an informed decision. As per Kaveh Solheko, this is a reporter for or correspondent for Sky Sports, he says that the second bid in business, it's expected to be higher than the first bid, but he doesn't rule out a situation where the second bid is lower, because if you review this stadium and of course the facilities, and you think there is a lot that needs to be done even after buying the club, so you need to submit a lower bid, because you can't submit something higher in a situation where you don't see value for your money. And so what I can say for now is that the process is has entered its second phase, and of course in the coming days we expect fresh bids from both Sheikh and Sir Jim Ratcliffe. And also, this is from my own observation, I think Sheikh Jassim is the most probable, or is likely to win this, because I've seen Sir Jim Ratcliffe before with the sale of Chelsea, who was one of those bidders who are interested, or he was a suitor in this one, but he was not ready to offer the valuation, which was about 3 billion. And in this, having had the Glazers valuation of 6 billion, I know Manchester United is a different club in terms of history and even the achievements and everything, but I still think Sir Jim Ratcliffe is somehow stingy, let me put it that way. And going head to head with Sheikh Jassim, I think at the end of it all, it will be Sheikh Jassim who is likely to win it. Also, from the fans' point of view, they want the Qatari ownership, because it has been reported that Sheikh Jassim wants to buy 100% of the club shares, so buy the club everything and of course improve the facilities. But as per Jim, for Jim Ratcliffe, he owns 69% of the club, and that is the shares owned by the Glazers, because as you will notice, the club Manchester United of course is owned by shares, where the Glazers own 69%, and of course the others is from the fans, fan forums and so on, fan investment schemes. So for Jim, he owns 69%. That is the exact amount of shares owned by the Glazers. But for Sheikh Jassim, he owns everything, and of course, you know, the Arabs are ready to splash any amount on making sure that the club is back to its highest level. So that's the update up to now. If we have any developments in the coming days, I will let you know. But before that, make sure that you have subscribed to this channel, ring the bell so that every time I drop new content, in case there are developments and of course other news away from Manchester United, you will be the first one to get notified.